Hi, I'm Yingying, and welcome to USD in Bifrost. This tutorial series focuses on the basic structure of USD and its workflow in the recently released Bifrost 2.4, which combines the power of USD and procedural content creation. If you're new to Bifrost, I recommend you watch our Intro to Bifrost series before this one. I've included the link in the description. USD stands for Universal Scene Description. It is a framework developed by Pixar Animation Studios to increase pipeline efficiency and facilitate collaborations. It provides a common language for defining, assembling, and editing data. All these sound very abstract, doesn't it? To make it more comprehensible, I created a diagram showing its elements and structure. As its name suggests, USD describes how a scene is assembled from individual assets. Each scene graph is called a stage. A USD stage is a 3D scene composed of USD layers. For example, in this case, we have a layer for the monster, one for their dwelling, and another one for the environment. Say we have three artists, each working on one asset. With USD, these can be quickly assembled into a scene. The basic container for USD object is called a prim. A prim can contain other prims, which creates a namespace hierarchy. It can also contain attributes such as color and transformation. We can easily modify the attributes without overriding the original files. We can also create variant sets, which allows us to switch between different options such as colors, sizes, and styles. When we save a stage, each layer is exported as one USD file, which can be referenced later. The common language and non-destructive workflow of USD facilitate artists to simultaneously work on the same scene in either the same or different applications, make modifications as they need, and try out different compositions without erasing or editing any other artist's work. With Bifrost, we can create USD assets and reuse them to quickly construct complex scenes, such as generating a large assembly and creating multiple materials, which we'll cover in this tutorial series. In this first tutorial, you'll learn how to create a USD stage. I'll show you how to create a layer, define a prim, and assign attributes. I've included the Maya file in the description for you to follow along. Without further ado, let's go to the Maya file and create a new Bifrost graph. To work with USD, we also want to have the USD Layer Editor handy. We can find it under Windows, General Editors. Here's what we're going to do today. We'll create an empty stage. Then we'll define a prim named Monster, which contains two child prims, body and eyes, and we'll add the colors and transformations. Now let's see how to do it in Bifrost. First, let's get the node Create USD Stage. Go to the parameters and select the location where you want to store the USD files. Let's name the file monster.usd. To add prims to a stage, you can use the node addToStage. Connect the empty stage we just created to the port stage. Right-click Add Prim Definitions. Under Create Node, select Define USD Prim. This provides a prim definition for the addToStage node to create a prim and add it to the stage. Let's take a look at the parameters of the Define USD Prim node. Here we can specify the path for this prim, for example, slash monster. For the type of the prim, the default one is X-form, which means transform. It acts as a parent for other prims so that they can be moved, rotated, or scaled all together simultaneously. Other prim types are listed in the in-app docs, such as scope, capsule, cube, and mesh. Here we're creating a parent prim, so X-form is the type that we use. Now let's add the body and eyes as the children of this parent prim. Here I have the body that I modeled earlier in Maya. Let's middle drag it into the Bifrost graph editor. To create a child of a parent prim, hover your mouse over children, right-click, under Create node, select the type of the prim that you are about to define. The body of our monster is a mesh, so we select Define USD Mesh. Rename the path to Body. Connect the body to mesh. And outstage to the output. Let's hide the original mesh. Now we have a monster body, which is stored in this USD stage. When we connected the stage to the output, it also generated this Maya USD proxy object in the outliner. If we expand it, we'll see the hierarchy. Here monster is the parent prim, and it has a child called body. Now let's take a look at the USD layer editor. In this editor, we can see all the USD layers that we created in the graph. With the default setting, when we create the stage, it generates this unshareable layer as the root layer. And the layers that we create in the graph will be the sublayers underneath this root layer. With this unshareable layer, if we move the object, the transformation will be written into this root layer. If we right-click and select Print to Script Editor, we see this translation here. This means even after we disconnect the stage from the output and reconnect it, we still have this transformation, because every time we transform the object in the viewport, the operations are written into this unshareable layer. If we select Maya USD Proxy 1 in the outliner, go to the Attribute Editor, under Stage, check Shareable, then immediately we see that the transformation is gone. Because when shareable is on, it doesn't create that unshareable layer. We can see it here, now we only have the monster.usd layer that we created in the graph. This means that any manual transformation in the viewport won't be recorded. For example, if I drag it, disconnect the stage from the output, and reconnect it, I got the original location instead of the translated one. We want to keep shareable on all the time when creating a USD stage in Bifrost. This allows us to directly access the stage and see which layer is targeted, which we'll talk more about in later tutorials. After we complete the Bifrost graph, we may switch to the unshareable mode if we want to do some manual adjustments and have them memorized for later use. In Bifrost USD, we can also add attributes to a prim. For example, if we want to change the color of the monster, we can go to Attribute Definitions, right-click, under Create Node, select Define USD Display Color. And we can pick any color that we like. If we print this layer to the script editor, we can see both the structure of the layer and the attributes of the prims. Here we have the parent prim monster, whose type is X-form, and it contains a child prim named Body, and its type is Mesh. Here are the details of this prim, such as face vertex counts, indices, and the coordinates of the vertices. And this is the color attribute that we just added. That's the body of our monster. Now let's add the eyes. We want the two eyes to act as a group, so let's create a USD prim with the type X-form as a container for the two eyes. Rename the path to eyes. And then define a mesh prim. Copy and paste it. Rename them to left eye and right eye, respectively. get a create mesh sphere. Connect it to the left eye. At this moment, it has the wrong size and wrong location. To change the size and location of a prism, we can add a transform attribute. Similar to how we added the color, right-click at Attribute Definitions, under Create Node, select Define USD Transform. Here we can change the scale and translate it to the right location. By holding down Shift, we can multi-select values and change them at the same time. Now let's connect the mesh sphere to the right eye as well. Copy and paste this transform node. Invert the x value of the translation and connect it to the attribute definitions. Let's also get a defined USD display color. And set it to black. We can also add a transform node at the parent level so that we can move both eyes at the same time. Similarly, we can add a transform attribute to the monster level, and this moves everything together. If we look at the structure now, we see that we have the prism monster as the parent, which has two children, the body and the eyes. And the prism eyes also has two children, the left eye and right eye. Let's also take a look at the USD layer. Here we have the parent prism monster, its children, body and eyes, and grandchildren, left eye and right eye. Here's the transformation for everything together, the transformation for both eyes, and the transformation for each individual eye. And we can also find the color information for the prims. That's it for today. To recap, we created a stage and added a prim, which contains two children, the body and the eyes. All these are stored in one layer. In the next tutorial, we'll add another child to the prism monster, which is the flowers. For the flowers, we'll create a variant set so that we can choose between them. And we'll also learn how to save a USD stage. If you're also interested in Maya USD, be sure to watch my colleague Matt's series, USD Primer for Artists. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.